Hello students, myself Professor Ankur, and I welcome everyone for the gate theory session on analog circuits. Today we are going to start with an important topic, timer IC 555. So we are going for the first part of the timer session, IC 555 introduction. So let's start with the theory session on IC 555 introduction. So what is basically IC 555 timer? We want circuitries which will produce particular types of oscillation and produce square pulses or rectangular pulses of variable duty cycle. So for that, we are going to use a specific timer IC defined as IC 555. It is basically an integrated circuitry used in variety of timer delay, pulse generation and oscillation applications. There are advanced version of IC 555. One of them is IC556 and other one is IC558, which will give you 2 and 4 timer circuits in one package respectively. Let's go for the internal structure. So now if you observe the internal structure, first of all, we need to understand IC555 is basically a 8-pin IC. In the 8-pin logic, we are having the first pin as ground pin, second pin as trigger pin, third pin will be output pin, fourth pin is reset pin, fifth pin is control pin, sixth pin is threshold pin, seventh pin is discharge pin, and eighth pin is VCC pin. So overall, we are having 8 pins for this timer IC 555. So now let's discuss small consideration for the internal structure. So in the internal structure, you can observe clearly there is a SR flip-flop placed at the center with input pins S and R and the output pins Q and Q bar, where the Q bar pin of the flip-flop will actually work like an output pin for the IC timer. The Q pin is connected to a transistor via the resistor R, which will actually work under a concept of closed switch and open switch application, implies the transistor is going to work like a switch. So it will actually operate in the saturation region or in the cutoff region. So depending on the status of Q, the status of your transistor will keep on changing. Now, the inputs to the pin S and R is actually coming from two comparators. The first comparator is normally called as the upper comparator, and the second comparator is normally called as the lower comparator. So for the comparator, we require reference points or reference voltages. So for that, we are having a battery of 5 volt supply. That will be the VCC, which will be connected externally to the chip. And then that voltage will be used for bifurcation, or you can say terminal voltage determination with respect to 3 resistances, each of 5 kilo ohm. So internally inside the structure, you will have 3 resistance each of 5K, and the voltage will come externally from the VCC supply. Normally we try to keep the VCC value to 5 volts. So now let's understand how the comparators will generate its reference voltages. So we are having VCC at the top, and there are 3 resistances each of 5 kilo ohm. So 5K, 5K and 5K. So if you observe carefully, the drop across every resistor will be as good as 1/3 of VCC. So if I see the lower comparator, since there are 2 comparators, upper comparator and lower comparator, every comparator is having 2 input points, plus point and a minus point. So if I see the lower comparator, the plus point is holded with a drop of 5 kilo ohm resistor. So that drop will be corresponding to 1/3 of VCC. Automatically, the minus pin of the comparator will be controlled using a trigger. So if I try to interpret a small understanding regarding the second comparator, I can easily say that whenever the trigger signal goes below 1/3 of VCC, automatically the lower comparator will give an output 1. So what will be the impact? If the lower comparator gives you an output 1, the R pin of the flip-flop will receive 1. Now going for the upper comparator, if you see the upper comparator, again there are 2 input pins, plus and minus pin. So the plus pin is controlled to the threshold, and the minus pin is basically attached directly to the reference point. So if I see carefully, since there are 2 5 kilo ohms of that value, and then when I see the voltage drop across every resistor as 1/3 and 1/3 VCC, automatically when I add the two drops, the total value becomes 2/3 VCC. So it is as good as, for the upper comparator, the reference control voltage corresponds to 2/3 VCC. Whereas for the lower comparator, the control voltage corresponds to 1/3 VCC. But if you observe the connections carefully, for the lower comparator, the connection is for the plus pin. So it is as good as the reference potential is given to the plus pin. So whatever happens at trigger, the trigger is getting compared with respect to the plus pin. But when you see the top comparator minus pin is connected to 2/3 VCC. So automatically, whatever happens at the threshold pin, that will decide the status or the output of the comparator 1. So I can easily say that whenever the plus pin of the comparator 1 will cross the level of 2/3 VCC, then only the upper comparator 1 will give you an output 1. So if the upper comparator gives you 1, the S will become 1. Now the logic understanding happens with respect to the SR flip-flop. So in the SR flip-flop concept, we need to understand that the S pin and the R pin will control the status of Q and Q bar. Whenever S will become 1, Q will become 1, so Q bar will become 0. And whenever R will become 1, Q will become 0, automatically Q bar will become 1. Q and Q bar are actually complement of each other. So what happens when the Q is either 1 or 0? If the Q is 1, the transistor will turn on and it will work like a closed switch. And if the Q is 0, automatically transistor will turn off and it will work like an open switch. So this is all regarding a small concept regarding the internal structure of IC555 timer. So as I've discussed, there are 8 pins for the IC555. So pin number 1 will be corresponding to the ground. It is basically the ground reference voltage. Pin number 2 is a trigger pin, which will work like an input pin. It is responsible for transition of the SR flip-flop. Pin number 3 is an output pin, output driven waveform. Pin number 4 is the reset pin. Pin number 5 corresponds to the control voltage. The controls, it controls the width of the output pulse by controlling the threshold and the trigger levels. Pin number 6 corresponds to threshold. It is again an input pin. Compares the voltage applied at a terminal with a reference voltage of 2/3 VCC. Pin number 7 is the discharge pin, connected to open collector of a transistor, which discharges a capacitor between intervals. So the capacitor will be actually connected externally to the chip so that it can actually discharge accordingly the position with respect to the discharge pin. Pin number 8 is your VCC supply. That is basically your supply voltage. As I've discussed, normally it will be kept at 5 volts. So now we are trying to understand a small elaborate discussion with respect to the internal structure. So as I've said that there are 3 5K resistors, and now they will divide the voltage VCC equally. So now when I talk about the upper comparator and the lower comparator, the upper comparator has a reference comparison with respect to 2/3 VCC, and the lower comparator will have a reference comparison with respect to 1/3 VCC. And that we have also discussed, that whenever we talk about the lower comparator, when the trigger input will go below 1/3 VCC, the lower comparator will give you an output 1. Automatically, R will become 1, Q will become 0, Q bar will become 1. If the Q becomes 0, transistor will become off and it will work like an open switch. Now, the opposite logic is for the upper comparator. Whenever the signal just tries to cross 2/3 VCC, automatically upper comparator will become 1. If the upper comparator becomes 1, in that case, the output is 1, S will become 1, Q will become 1, Q bar will become 0. If Q is becoming 1, the transistor will turn on and it will work like a closed switch. So this is the way in which the internal operation of the IC555 will come into picture. So now we are trying to understand in how many modes we can actually operate the IC555 timer. So the circuitry can be operated in 3 modes: monostable mode, an astable mode, and bistable mode. The basic logic happens with respect to astable and bistable and monostable. So now when I talk about the monostable mode, in the monostable mode, IC555 will work like a one-shot pulse generator. Eventually, what we want here is, for whatever is the input, we need to create a pulse. So now when you give a trigger signal, for a particular trigger signal, it will generate a waveform of specific width. So that is the concept of monostable circuitry. A stable circuitry is a concept where it will actually work like a oscillator or a generator. So it is going to generate square pulses or rectangular pulses of different time period or width depending on the circuit arrangement. And in bistable, it will actually work like a flip-flop. So in all, there are three modes of IC555: monostable mode, a stable mode, and bistable mode. The normal connections are coming into picture with respect to monostable and a stable. Thank you.